Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Land of Empires Immortal on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5 that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Land of Empires Immortal and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Land of Empires Immortal. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all buddies, the first thing to do is to open our favorite browser. We have here the one we prefer. Let's go to that URL I'm highlighting in green. Now, you can discover on the screen. You don't need to type the URL, simply because I provided a link in the video description and the first main comment. We landed at this point on the website of Usitility, exactly where we get a meticulous explanation on how you can download Land of Empires Immortal on laptop or computer. We scroll lower a little bit and click on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on this link, we get to the website of BlueStacks. No panic, it is only the Android emulator that we are going to run to get access to the game Land of Empires Immortal on our PC. It is now obvious that we get some advantages of running this emulator. Now we are ready to start downloading the Land of Empires Immortal by clicking on the button Play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green color. Next step is clicking on it. And the download takes no time at all. Here it is, this is the download. It's an executable file. What we are going to do now is to run the installer, so we click on this file. If we are on Windows 10 it will have asked us for permission to allow modifications to the device. We answered yes. I minimized the internet browser to find the installer better. The installer is really straightforward. It contains two choices, install, and setup path. I am going to make it clear what setup path really does. We just click on it. And we realize that we end up with here the path where the emulator is going to be set up. If we are planning to modify this directory we must click on that browse button, and therefore we pick another directory and install the emulator precisely where we prefer. To keep it simple, just keep it where it is. Then, I click on back. And I just click install. Now, there it is. The setup begins and it will move forward together with the download of all these megabytes which are displayed on our screen. As you save it on your hard disk, it could be more or less MB. The download rate will go at a higher speed or at a lower speed, determined by your internet and according to the data transfer rate of the emulator web servers. At the moment they are progressing extremely fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. Now, the emulator happens to be started automatically. As you can see, at the bottom of the screen, there's a progress bar that will fill up so when it has reached the end, the emulator is going to be launched for the first time. In fact the emulator has been started, here it is for the first time. Before we continue, as now you can see, it has made two software icons right here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon will be the one we're considering. Every time we desire to operate Land of Empires Immortal on our desktop or laptop, we twice mouse click on this specific app icon and therefore launch the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let's conduct the following step, which is a requirement, and that's to visit the Google Play Store. And we'll just click on Play Store. As you can see the Google Play is started. Right here we have to sign in. Now once we're here, we have to begin doing this next step that is mandatory. Therefore simply click on Sign In. Now it shows Checking Info. It could sometimes get blocked in Checking Info and this fails to move ahead. If so, you may attempt to log in after a couple of hours but it will surely most probably be repaired. Now we can insert our login name and password. The email really needs to be a Gmail email and its corresponding password. As an example you may use the exact same email address you are using at this time in your own YouTube account. So that I will type my details and I'll come back immediately after I have accomplished it. That's it, info typed in. Here is Google welcoming us and providing us the twos. We will agree to them by just hitting, I agree. Next, it make us possible to save to the Google Cloud. You can let it checked and this will produce a backup of the data files on this device to Google Drive. I am not going to select it, you do what you want. We click accept. Google Play is started automatically and automatically. To set up the app game, we would need to visit the Android emulator desktop by clicking on the icon designated green colored. Now that we are discovering the desktop of this emulator, we observe that we now have there the install video game button. We click on this button. Here we come with the game app. So let's press there on the install choice that I am displaying now in green. And it will launch the software installation. At this moment it should download on your desktop or laptop and set up the video game. It will take a while, or perhaps it could possibly be very quick. This all relies upon on the connection to the web. This has just completed setting up. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by clicking this particular button that I'm presenting in green, if you want to run Land of Empires Immortal for the first time. We are currently on the emulator desktop, and therefore we are about to just click on the new Land of Empires Immortal app icon that has been provided. The game app is started for the very first time. Now there we get it, I am able to click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will discuss the volume level of the emulator. It's here. We use the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume, this way we will not use the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound of this emulator. And to take pleasure in the experience to the maximum, we can switch on the big screen, for which we have two options. This is actually the first one, we mouse click on this particular software icon which I am mentioning in green. And the monitor is maximized, offering one border at the top, one on the right side and one at the bottom. If we need to have fun with the game in full screen, we click that app icon. And we'd at present be enjoying the game app in full screen function. To leave the 100% screen mode, just click the F11 key. And we would certainly now be in regular computer screen setting. Now I am on the way to demonstrate to you the keyboard mapping that is actually surprisingly appealing. This way we will probably be capable to make use of the video game much more easily. The very first task is to mouse click this application icon. It's now time to get the necessary configuration settings. I am about to let the default configuration, but if you require to modify that, you can easily achieve it with no problem. Obviously, the emulator is fully in our own language. From time to time it happens that the emulator is presented in the incorrect language, as an example, in Chinese. And to place it in the proper language we browse here to the cogwheel. And there inside of other options, we just click on the language drop down. We will opt for the language we like, English, Mandarin, and so on. When the language is selected, we should save, the emulator would reboot, and also the Android game, next time we use it, will also be in the preferred language. Now, you can find another information that we must take into account, and it's that we will get a message from Gmail indicating that a new electronic device has been linked to our own Google account. It will certainly ask us if we are the people who have associated with that electronic device. Absolutely, we really should not be troubled, because the emulator is behaving like a Google Android smartphone or tablet. And to determine which smartphone or tablet is being emulated, we return here, to the cogwheel and we mouse click on it. And we browse here to the, model, choice. And here we notice that the emulator is acting as a Samsung smartphone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all guys, so much for that tutorial. I anticipate you enjoyed it, especially that you found it useful. If that's so, offer it a nice like, subscribe, and any remarks, issues or ideas, let them in the comment area down below. You can also leave comments on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams on occasion, you get it down below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Simply click on any of those video tutorials that happens to be showing up on the screen and see you in the following online videos. Bye.